Music with Missy Theer. Yes, it's gonna be real fun. We will work together now. One for all and all for one. You will learn to dance and sing. La 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 la. Oh, what joy the music brings. So get ready. Howdy, friends! Welcome back to another music lesson, and let's get started with some hello songs, shall we? How about we... clap to the beat, ready? Hello, hello, I'm so very glad to see you. Hello, hello, how are you today? Hello, hello, I'm so very glad to see you. Hello, hello, how are you today? How about this time I'm going to tap my table. And I bet you probably have a table in front of you too. Let's try, ready? Hello, hello, I'm so very glad to see you. Hello, hello, how are you today? Hello, hello, I'm so very glad to see you. Hello, hello, how are you today? Ooh, I just thought of something cool we could do. What if we take those two different movements that we just did and smoosh them together? Remember the first time we clapped, and then this last time we were patting the table. What if we put those together and turned it into a pattern like this? Pat, clap, pat, clap. Can we try it? Hello, hello, I'm so very glad to see you. Hello, hello, how are you today? Hello, hello, I'm so very glad to see you. Hello, hello, how are you today? Ooh, I like the sound of that. Okay, let's try, let's do our shoulders, ready? Hello, hello, I'm so very glad to see you. Hello, hello, how are you today? Hello, hello, I'm so very glad to see you. Hello, hello, how are you today? Now let's go up to our head, ready? Hello, hello, I'm so very glad to see you. Hello, hello, how are you today? Hello, hello, I'm so very glad to see you. Hello, hello, how are you today? Now let's take those two movements, the shoulders and the head, and let's turn that into a pattern. Are you ready? It's gonna look like this, right? Here we go. Hello, hello, I'm so very glad to see you. Hello, hello, how are you today? Hello, hello, I'm so very glad to see you. Hello, hello, how are you today? Nice work, everybody. Thanks for doing the hello song.
Alrighty, friends, Mrs. Ethier here with a really fun body percussion activity for us to do. And it happens to be to one of my very favorite Disney songs, which is Under the Sea, do-do-do, Under the Sea, do-do-do-do. I really like that song. And this is really fun body percussion. So I'm going to push play on it, but I'm going to pause it so you can see. First of all, I'm going to make it really big. That's a different teacher's bitmoji. Okay, so I'm going to get this out of the way. So here are the different symbols that we have. We've got a snap. And if you can't snap, friends, then just pretend no one will know the difference, right? We have pat, so you're going to pat your legs for that. Or I could pat the table too if I'm sitting at a table. Clap is an obvious one. And stomp. Now, when we see the stomp symbol in this particular song, sometimes you'll see an R next to it or an L. Sometimes you'll see an R symbol next to it or an L symbol. And that stands for right leg or your left leg. So sometimes you're just stomping with the right and sometimes it's just with the left, okay? And then a rest is just a silent rest as always. Can we do it? Of course we can. Psh, yeah, let's do this thing. Let's get groovy, people. They got up there. Ready? Pat, pat. It's always greener in somebody else's lake. You dream about going up there, but that is a big mistake. Just look at the world around you, right here on the ocean floor. Such wonderful things around you. What more are you looking for? Ready? Under the sea. Under the sea. Darling, it's better down where it's wetter. Take it from me. I'm on the shore, they work all day. Out in the sun, they slave away. While we devoting full time to floating under the sea. New pattern, ready? Down here on the fish is happy as I flew the waves they roll. The fish on the land is happy. This hot Thursday in the bowl. But fish in the bowl is lucky. They in for a worse fate. One day when the boss get hungry, yes, you go beyond the plate. Uh-oh. Under the sea. Under the sea. Nobody beat us, fry us, and eat us in fricassee. We want the land folks loves to cook. Under the sea. We got off the hook. We got no troubles. Like I fish the bubbles. Under the sea. Under the sea. Pat. Since life is sweet here, we got to be here naturally. Naturally. Even the sturgeon and the ray. Did the earth start to play? We got the spirit, you got to hear it. Under the sea. Oh, here we go. Right. Left. Right. Left. The job, the bass play, the brass, the chub play, the top. The flute is the duke of soul. Right. Left. Right. Left. She sings the spelt and the sprat. They know where it's at. They know that blowfish blow. Oh, dance break. Oh, yeah. We got the moves. Go swimming, people! And then we dive. I'll get ready, here it comes. New pattern, ready?
Under the sea, under the sea. When the sardine begin, 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 it's music to me. What do they got?
A lot to send. We got the hot crustacean band. Ready? Right. Left. Right. Left. Right. Left. Right. Left. Do 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 a big final pose. Whatcha? Fantastic work, everybody. That was amazing. I really felt like I was under the sea. How about you guys? I hope you had fun. Thanks for doing it with me, everybody.
Hello, folks. I have a story to share with you today. It's called My Many Colored Days, and it's actually a story by Dr. Seuss. It's not, you know, like the Cat in the Hat or things like that. It's a little bit different sounding, but it is by Dr. Seuss, and Dr. Seuss just had his birthday, didn't he? So it's kind of fun that we're doing a Dr. Seuss story. And in this one, he's talking about different colors, so My Many Colored Days, and how different colors can express different emotions. But we also know that music can cause different feelings and different emotions when we listen to it as well. So we're kind of connecting colors and music and emotions today, which is going to be kind of fun. It kind of makes me think of the movie Inside Out, if you've seen that one, where all the different emotions are different colors, right? Sadness is blue and anger is red. Fear is purple and disgust is green. And joy is yellow, right? She has blue hair, but she's mostly yellow. So, let's read our story, shall we? It's a really good one. You'll like it. It goes like this. Some days are yellow. Some are blue. On different days, I'm different too. Do you feel that sometimes? Like, sometimes you'll hear somebody say, wow, somebody woke up on the wrong side of the bed. Have you ever had that happen to you? Where you just wake up and you just feel grumpy for some reason. You don't even know why. Or maybe you wake up and you're really excited about something. So that can change the whole feeling of your day, or in this case, the color of your day. Some days are yellow and some are blue. You'd be surprised how many ways I change on different colored days. On bright red days, how good it feels to be a horse and kick my heels. So Dr. Seuss's version of red is kind of excited, right? An excited horse. On other days, I'm other things. On bright blue days, I flap my wings. I like the pictures to this book too. Some days, of course, feel sort of brown. Then I feel slow and low, low down. Have you ever had that where it's kind of a lazy feeling day where you just don't want to do anything or just tired? I think that's what a brown day is. Then comes a yellow day, and wee! I am a busy, buzzy bee. I know I've had those kind of days too, where I'm just excited all day long, and I just have tons of energy. Gray day, everything is gray. I watch, but nothing moves today. Looks like a cool owl, right? Then all of a sudden, I'm a circus seal. On my orange days, that's how I feel. Green days, deep, deep in the sea, cool and quiet fish, that's me. On purple days, I'm sad. I groan, I drag my tail, I walk alone. Oh, that's sad. But we all have those kind of days sometimes, don't we? Where we just feel kind of sad or mopey and we just want to be alone, right? But when my days are happy, pink, I jump, it's great to jump and just not think. Ooh, pink days are happy days. Look at those flamingos. I love that color. Really pretty. Then come my black days, mad and loud. I howl, I growl at every cloud. Have you ever had an angry wolf day? I think we all have. Then comes a mixed up day, and wham, I don't know who or what I am. That's the thing about those emotions, right? They can change. You might be happy for a while and then have a sad part of your day, right? But it all turns out all right, you see. And I go back to being me. And that's the end. So it doesn't matter what color day it is. You're always you no matter what, aren't you? Awesome. So in just a few minutes, we're going to have our conclusion and we'll talk about what your assignment is. And it has to do with colors and music and emotions and what music makes us feel. Thanks for reading with me.
Alrighty, friends. So for our movement activity today, we get to do something with scarves. Now, if you were in my classroom, you know that I have super cool colored scarves that make this cool, like flowy look when you use them. Obviously, we're not in my class right now, unfortunately. So we have to be creative. So I just went and found a scarf in my closet. You could use a scarf, you could use a dish towel, you could use, I don't know, be creative, I guess, to find something you could use as a scarf. And what's going to happen is the music's going to play. It's a really fun song called ABC. It's an old song by the Jackson 5, but I bet you'll have heard it before. It's a pretty great song. And they're going to give us directions of different ways to move our scarves during this song. Sometimes we'll be kind of painting like a picture with our scarves, and sometimes they'll kind of give us a word and we have to do that word with the scarves and things like that. So it's really kind of fun. So take a second to find a scarf to use. I'm going to use my Seahawks scarf. Whoop, whoop, Seahawks, yeah. And let's do it. Are you ready? Oh, yeah. Oh, here. All right, we're going to make a wave, people. Ooh, we're swishing out and out. Out. Ooh, wiggle. Now, folks, I'm doing this seated, but you can certainly stand up and move all around your room, okay? Ooh, we're making mountains. Mountains. Ooh, like a roller coaster. Going upside down. Ooh, swish. I think swish kind of means like a swishing across. Swish. Oh, make a circle. Make a big circle. Oh, I'm going to make a Mickey Mouse. I'll make little ears. Ooh, swirl. I'm going to swirl mine like a tornado. Wow. Ooh, make a big X with your scarf. We know this song, everybody. Do you recognize it? Oh, make a big arch. Big arch. Nice job. Ooh, switch hands. You got this. Ah. Oh, up and down. Like you're making big up and down lines. Ooh, your choice. Ah, what am I gonna do? Oh, yeah. We'll make a square. Ooh, wiggles down. I like that one. Oh, happy face. We did it. Fantastic, everybody. Did you get a chance to try it out with a scarf? I really hope so. Nice work. That was really fun.
Hello, folks. So just a little bit ago, we read My Many Colored Days by Dr. Seuss. And we talked a little bit about how different colors can kind of make us feel different emotions. Or if we're feeling blue, that kind of means sad or things like that. Well, we can have kind of the same idea with music, can't we? Doesn't certain kind of music make us feel a certain way? So I want us to really think about that, about how music is making you feel. We're going to listen to some different examples of music. And I just want you to listen for a moment and think about what emotion this music would make you feel. Now, there are really no right or wrong answers here because what we feel might be a little bit different from what someone else feels, but it's still important to think about how things make you feel. And again, there's not a right or wrong answer. So let's try this one. You've probably heard this before. Think about how it makes you feel. Isn't that a pretty song? It's called Spring, by the way. It's from The Four Seasons, and this is the spring section by Antonio Vivaldi. And I don't know about you, it may be different, but for me, listening to that music just makes me feel happy. It's just a really nice, happy tune, okay? Let's try this one. Again, you'll probably have heard this before. This is my favorite part. Whew! Did that make you feel kind of scared? Is that kind of scary music? It did for me. And we know that music can make us feel that way, especially when we're watching like a spooky movie or something pops out of nowhere and we hear this surprising music. It can make us feel surprised or even scared, right? Try this one. Ooh, I love that one. That's called the William Tell Overture. And again, I don't know about you at home, but for me, it makes me feel really excited. Like I'm watching a horse race or, I don't know, some big racing movie where it's like, oh, I'm so excited. That's what that makes me feel. Okay, how about this one? This is a final example, and then we'll have an assignment that goes with this. I bet you know this song. What do you think about that one? It's a really great song, isn't it? For me, it makes me think of being angry and having like a fight with somebody, not a physical fight, but like by a speaking fight, like, I'm angry, is what it makes me feel like. It could be different for you. So that just gives you an example of all the different things that a different piece of music can make you feel, okay? So for your assignment today, I'm going to play you an example of some music right now. And I just want you to listen and think about how that music makes you feel. And I want you to send it to me. You could send me words, like you could just type out, it makes me feel excited, or it makes me feel happy. You could send a little video of you explaining how it made you feel. You could draw a picture of it, maybe. However you want to do it, friends, but I want to know how this particular piece of music makes you feel, okay? So I'm going to turn it on. We're just going to listen for a minute. Again, I bet you'll recognize it. Okay, so think about how that music made you feel, and I'd love to hear what you think. And again, friends, there's no right or wrong answer, but I just want to know. I'm curious, okay? So have a wonderful week, everybody. Bye-bye.